All right, well, thank you very much for coming here today. And I am here at Grace Gallery in Brantford, Ontario. As you can see, I got wonderful paintings behind me. These are original works by national, international, and local artists here in Brantford, Ontario. I am here with a wonderful guest. Her name is Arielle Vina. And she is an actress, model, singer, and dancer. So, would you like to give yourself a small introduction before we get started?
Of course, of course. Also, I want to say thank you so much for having me here. I'm so excited to be here. And hello, everybody. I'm Ariel, and I love to sing, act, and model.
All right. One of the things that I'm going to continue on with the introduction is she is actually a 3 gold, 2 silver, 2 bronze recognition award champion of the world in modeling category for 2019 World Championship of Performing Arts Champion. She is also the Youth Talk Ambassador for 2019, and she is also the 2019-2020, I'm not sure how to pronounce that, but Pinabet Seeds of Hope Ambassador. I don't think I pronounced that first word.
It's all good. You're great. You're great.
Okay, good. All right. So that is a small introduction for Arielle. All right. So we are going to go on to the questionnaire. So
yes.
First question. What was the first thought you had about going back to school when you have been out for many months?
Well, I guess you could say the first thing I felt was excitement because, like, you know, I've been out for so long, and I also kind of missed it too because I miss my friends and just doing work, I guess, and keeping myself. And I went to high school this year. It's my first year in high school.
Oh, wow. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I hope you're enjoying that. I know my first year in high school was not the most enjoyable, but I hope yours is. All right. What kind of feelings or emotions did you have by going back to school?
Well, as I said, I was super nervous because, like, obviously going into high school, you don't have many friends, and there was no one from my elementary school that was going to my high school, so I was nervous, kind of scared, but in the past 2 weeks that I've been in school, I've made lots of friends, and I've made a lot of new connections, and I do go to an art school, so I get to, like, meet other people who love what I love.
Oh, wow, you go to an art school. That's pretty cool.
Yes.
Well, you know what? I had a totally different experience because here in high school, for me, it was just a repeat of the very same classmates I've had all through my whole life because I'm in a small town, right? I'm in a small town. At that time, it was about 50,000 people, you know, 60,000 people. It was not that big of a city. And basically it was, basically all the same people you grew up with were all your high school students too. So it was like, I already knew everybody. I already went to school with everybody. The whole 1,500 students were all students I knew through all my years of schooling. So it was like a totally different experience.
Yeah, like the complete opposite.
Yeah. So 3, what is one fond thing you can think of that you have done or remember over the COVID time?
I'd say one thing is just, like, picking up a bunch of new hobbies. I definitely tried way more things this year. I picked up sewing, and I baked with my family, and I also kind of picked up skateboarding recently. I'm still learning, though, and I'm still exploring all the hobbies, and I'm actually having a lot of fun. I had more fun than I expected I would.
Excellent. 4, what is one thing you did as a family during COVID that you consider a good memory?
I'd say just going on family walks, because since we were cooped up inside all day, we would just like go on a walk here and there. And it was just fun to be outside. And, you know, any time is good with your family. What about you? What about you? What's one of your favorite memories with your family?
Oh, my. Well, I have definitely been doing a lot more walking, same thing, doing hikes and stuff like
yes.
that. I've been hanging out with a few of my friends a bit more. And we've been going, I'm a long distance walker. So one day I walked all the way to Ayr from Brantford, and it was 6.5 hours one way. And then I had to walk another 6.5 hours back. So that's 13 hours in one day walking.
Just wow. That's crazy. I don't know if I would be able to survive that.
It's not that bad, but, yeah, so that's what I do. I normally do about 5-6 hours walk per walk. So it's
oh, that's not cool.
Yeah. All right, number 5. How has COVID affected your life as a model entertainer?
Well, obviously a lot of things have been canceled because of COVID or postponed, like this event, but I am so looking forward to just it going back to normal and like me experiencing all these new things. And also, since everything was online, like I got to kind of do be more tech savvy, because I'm not really a tech savvy person. So I got to like explore the technology more, and who knows, it might be like this from now on, because like, you know, future's evolving, technology's evolving. So I don't know, it was a unique experience in terms of like classes and lessons and like things like that. But I think it went pretty smoothly for the most part, since no one was prepared for the pandemic.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's the same thing for me. I'm not tech savvy. I wasn't born in the millennial era. So I honestly have that programmed in my head. I was born in the typewriter era. So I was programmed to use a typewriter.
that's funny.
But basically, yeah, it was just, just me and technology. Sometimes takes some getting used to, but I quickly figured out how to host a Zoom meeting, which is actually really cool.
Oh, that's good.
That didn't take too much concentration or learning on my part. So that was pretty cool.
Fast learner.
It was pretty self-explanatory and pretty simple. I was actually surprised. All right, where are we now? Oh, yes. And thanks for bringing up the normal thing, too, because that's the next question. Number 6, do you see us returning to the old normal ever again?
I'd say people will still be more careful and, like, obviously take precautions. And they will always like remember this as something that we have to look out for. And who knows if this will happen again. We don't know if we're going to have a second wave. I think we are having a second wave actually right now. So I feel like it might not go back to normal. And if it ever does, I don't think it would be the normal that was once before. If that makes any sense.
Yep, absolutely. Number 7. Does wearing a mask face covering make you feel comfortable? Why or why not?
I feel like it does make me feel comfortable because of the safety. It makes me feel more safe. Even though like people are saying that being 6 feet apart works, some people are not always 6 feet apart from you. So it's just like another extra precaution. I think everyone should be wearing a mask. It's very important. And you don't even know if you have the virus. So it's important for you to wear a mask so you don't possibly spread whatever you have, and also you don't want whatever the other person has. So it's wearing a mask is probably the number one thing that I've learned from quarantine. Like, just being more safe and protective is always key.
Absolutely, and I agree with that 100%. And it's I'm still not 100% comfortable with it. And the reason why is because I do have exemptions. My exemptions are asthma and anxiety. And I also have had trauma in my life. So basically, those do exempt me, but however, I don't disobey the bylaw. I still uphold the bylaw. I still wear the mask in and out of stores, and I absolutely still wear the mask, of course, inside institutions where I'm required to wear a mask. And it has just become like another accessory. It really hasn't been a real factor. I don't really have a severe form of asthma. My asthma is a mild form, so it's not really that severe. So that is why I choose to wear a mask. And I have adjusted. I have completely adjusted, and I accept it because it's something that I know needs to happen.
Yes, I agree.
Number 8. As a model entertainer, how many hours do you normally practice?
It really depends on what I have going on that week, because I do have, since I've been in school, I do have homework, and I have extracurriculars besides like modeling and performing. So I would say I would try to do as much as possible, maybe 1 hour a day or a little bit more than that.
Okay, and 9, as a model entertainer, how much time is taken for preparations, travel, and music voice lessons, if any? And in your case, acting lessons too.
Yes. I like to schedule things like with other teachers. And I just overall, I think it would take me about like 45 minutes a week to like travel back and forth, or maybe more than that, maybe an hour or two to travel back and forth every week. Cause I actually live like close to where my vocal teacher, and since COVID-19 is calming down, I was able to go and see them in person. But other than that, I don't really think it takes me much preparation because most of them are online anyways.
Right. 10, if you can name one contest, concert, pageant, or event that you were a part of recently, which would it be and why?
I would say the Seeds of Hope Foundation. I did an event with them a little while back, and I'm actually one of the ambassadors, as you said in the introduction. And I don't know, I had a lot of fun at the event, and it was just a really nice calming event. And obviously there was social distancing precautions, and I had a lot of fun, and I got to talk to people because that was the first event when COVID kind of calmed down that I went to. So yeah, it just kind of stuck in my brain, and obviously I'm really excited for Mask It too.
All right, and number 11, if you have been in an interview or online event, which one was it, and what was your experience?
Well, I actually did a lot of online classes this little quarantine, and I actually did New York Film Academy. I did an acting a whole week. I did like this virtual acting class, and it was honestly so fun. I got to meet a lot of new people, and I just have so much in common with everyone. And I don't know, it just made me love what I do like even more. And the teachers were super, super cool. They've done a lot of stuff. And overall, I think that I would definitely go back, like in person, in real life, to New York just to go to the New York Film Academy courses again.
Nice. Number 12, are you comfortable with online events or in-person events? Which one do you like better and why?
I'd say I like in-person events more because, I don't know, it's just, it feels more comfortable with me since that's what I'm used to, obviously. But I don't mind doing online events. I think it's still fun. And I feel like, but in person, it's just, you get to interact more with your fellow performers, and you just get to be like more closer to them in a way. But I think that online events are a good substitute, and I don't mind doing them for the rest of the year, but I do prefer just doing in person.
Number 13, what has been your highest achievement to date as a model entertainer?
earlier you mentioned I was the model champion for 2019, and that is a really big accomplishment that I've achieved. Also, when I was in the competition, I did get a scholarship from New York Film Academy, so that's how I was able to go this summer to the online courses. And I feel like that's a really big accomplishment. And I was also in a short film like earlier this year in January, I believe, or sometime early this year. And that was a really big accomplishment for me. It was my first short film. And I just had a lot of fun with that.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
14, what is the best way for someone to contact you if they want to book you for an event?
Well, if you ever want to book me, you can reach out to me on Facebook or on Instagram. And my Instagram's Arielfina, and so is my Facebook. Or you can contact Aiden. I'm pretty sure he has my contact information.
All right, 15. This is the final question. Masked yes. Talent and Fashion Show 2020 is coming up in October. What would you like to, would you like to share a few words about this?
Of course. I am so excited for Mask It, and I feel like it's a good way to bring our community together and kind of like take a break from all this, whatever's going on in the world. And there's going to be so many amazing performers there. We just want to showcase their talents, and I'm pretty sure some of my friends are going to be there too, so I'm really excited to see them, and I cannot wait for the event. It's going to be a night to remember.
Yes, it certainly will, and I can't wait for it either. That's for sure. All right, is there any other announcements that you would like to make at this time? Anything for upcoming shows or anything?
I would just like to say thank you for having me here today, because I actually had so much fun, even though it was kind of short, but I actually just had so much fun, like just talking, you know?
Yeah, it's always good to just talk and have someone to speak to, you know, and just going through these times. I know these times are tough and rough for a lot of people, and it's nice to just, you know, socialize with somebody. And you know, I just thank you for your time and giving your time to Grace Gallery for this interview here today. So thank you, Arielle, and I will see you soon.
Yes,
have a great day. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.